Well, I got this center stringer mostly fiberglassed in. I actually did it a little bit different than I did the other four stringers that I've done, just because of the width of it or the height of it. So back here, I did it the way I had been doing the rest of them. I took both of my layers of 1708 and just laid it on the hole, went up and then over the stringer and laid it down on the hole. So it's all one piece all the way across. But up there, it's about 10 inches wide or so in some of those points, and it kind of varies pretty good in thickness, so it's kind of hard to cut out a nice piece of glass to go up and over that and have it even, extending evenly onto the hull and everything. So I decided to just do tabs like you would do if, you know, for most stringers if they're a lot taller. The reason I've been going up and over on these stringers is just because they're so short. I thought it would add more strength and it would be easy enough to go up and over, and it has been working out pretty well. But so the normal thing you do is you just tab onto the hull and you have up onto the stringer, so it's just one little corner piece basically. So I ended up doing that from about here on up to the front, and it worked out pretty well. But now, as you can see, I have to grind down the top a little bit where I had the glass coming up, you know, toward the top. I'm just going to grind it down just a little bit just to smooth it out, and then I'm going to take at least one piece of 1708, maybe two, and put a cap on the stringer and just run it down like a little piece, just extending onto both sides and wrapping over the top all the way up. And that'll finish that stringer up. So I'm pretty happy with how it turned out, and hopefully I'll be able to get some more resin soon. I don't have any more resin left, so I can't put that cap on there right now. So what I've been working on today is, as you can see, is starting to shape out my bulkheads here. Today is July 1st, so I guess technically I didn't meet my deadline of finishing the stringers by the end of June, because this center stringer is not quite done yet, but for all intents and purposes, this thing is in there and it's done. So, you know, I'm pretty happy with that. So hopefully, maybe by the end of July, I'll get this thing with the deck in it, and that'd be nice. Okay, I'm finally getting another chance to work on the boat. It's been probably about 3 weeks or so, almost a month maybe, that I haven't been able to work on the boat, just because I've been trying to save up a little bit more money to buy some more materials, and been busy with the end of the semester and everything. But back on it now, finally got a day off, and I'm getting ready to go ahead and peanut butter in my bulkheads. I got them coated in resin last night and got the areas where they're going to go down prepped out, and I'm going to hopefully get them in 1708 today, and that way I'll be probably 95 to 99% done with the structural stuff underneath the deck. There's still a few areas I gotta work out with the bilge and little drain holes and stuff, and then just some other things I gotta worry about before I can put the deck down, but it's getting close and I'm so excited. So let me go ahead and show you real quick before I get started here. So I don't remember if I showed the original layout of the bulkheads or not. I think I did, and I think I talked about it. But this is the final layout of the bulkheads. I eliminated four, I think. And I feel like this is going to be plenty strong. I mean, from the factory, this thing only had one bulkhead right up there. So, you know, this is definitely way more than it had from the factory. But anyways, you can see I just kind of staggered them out. Between the stringers, got three down the center and then two on the sides there. And I also have this one back here that I've been talking about. This one back here for the bilge area. And so that's gonna be real nice there. You can have that little square area back there. It's gonna be open. The deck's gonna go up to the edge there. So I can have a bilge area for the bilge pump and access the drain plug. And so I'm happy with the way these are laid out. Like I said, I'm going to get them in peanut butter, get my fillets done, and 1708, I'm going to try to go tab each one onto the stringers where they're butted up against, and then go down onto the hull as well. So it should be nice and strong when I get done with it. And I mean, this all this is going to be sealed up, so water should never get in here. but in case it does, all of my bulkheads have arches at the lowest point so the water can drain back down and come out the bilge back there. I think I mentioned it before, but these are going to have little drain plugs in them, those two, and then those stringers there, to where I can seal them off completely so the water should never get up under there. But if I think there's water there, I can take the little drain plugs out and the water should be able to come out. That's the idea. I'm not sure how good of an idea it is, but I'm going with it for now. I think it's kind of the best of both worlds. A lot of people just go ahead and completely seal up the underside of the deck, put foam in it and everything, but I didn't really want to go that route because it just kind of scares me to completely seal it up and not know what's going on down there. I mean, if you got water in underneath your floor, you got more problems anyways, I guess, but I just like the option of being able to open those little drain plugs back there and just check it every now and then, make sure I don't have any leaks or anything. So anyways, I'm gonna get to work and get these things peanut buttered in and glassed down. I didn't get everything done that I wanted to today, but I got through a lot of it. I could be working on a little bit more, but decided to call it quits today because my brother got this little aluminum StarCraft V-hole, and he's been working on it the past week or two, and we're getting ready to take it out for a little test drive this afternoon with some friends. So looking forward to that, and I'd rather do that than be out here in 100 degree weather and try to fiberglass this stuff because I've been doing it all day. But anyways, as you can see, I got all the bulkheads peanut buttered in, got my fillets made. It actually wasn't too hard. It didn't use up as much peanut butter as I thought it was going to. I was kind of light on it. I didn't put it on too heavy anyways, like I had on the stringers. And also, as you can see, I got these side supports here. I don't know if it had them from the factory, but there were some that somebody had added at some point, but they didn't fiberglass them in properly, so I tore them out just so they wouldn't get in the way of the floor and everything. But my plan is to eventually replace all of that structure. I just may not do it right away, but I figured it'd be a good idea to put these in because I can tab them into the hole and then put the floor up against through there, and that should stiffen it up real nice. So I got those cut out and glued together same way I did my bulkheads and got them peanut buttered in. And I got just the first few pieces of 1708 laid out on the bulkheads everywhere where I'm going to glass to attach it to the stringers there, and then I'm going to come back and tab into the hole as well with at least one layer, maybe two layers for the going into the hole since I have a bigger area. And that's pretty much it. So it didn't look like a lot of work, but it's a lot of work doing all that, and had to grind, you know, a few areas to where the bulkheads were going to go and the side supports just to touch everything up and prep it for glassing and everything. But next time I get to work on it, maybe Saturday tomorrow afternoon or maybe Sunday some point, we'll see. And I think I have some time next week as well, but I was hoping to get everything done by this end of this weekend so that next week I can maybe start working on the floor. But anyways, just want to make this update clip. For reference, today is July 27th, 2018. So, getting pretty close to August. Don't feel like I've made a lot of progress during July, but hopefully we'll be getting to the floor pretty soon. So, see you in the next clip. Alright guys, today is July 31st, and guess what? I am standing on the floor of this boat. I just got it test fit in there, just got it cut out, and I'm so excited to be able to get in this boat and stand on a floor, even if it's not fastened down yet. So I was able to finish up those four bulkheads toward the bow last night, or yesterday evening, and that's what prompted me to want to go ahead and get started on the floor. I'm sick of working on stringers and everything, so this morning I went and got two sheets of plywood, thinking that was going to take two sheets to do the bow section, but I managed to get it out of one sheet. So the other sheet I bought, I was able to start the deck back here, and this goes all the way to the back of the boat back here. And so I only need one more sheet to fill in this gap back here and on the starboard side, and that'll be only three sheets of plywood to do the whole floor. So I'm excited about that. It saves me like $30 because I was thinking I was gonna have to use four.
I'll talk a little bit more later on about the reason I did the seams the way they are, but just know right now that they fall on stringers, except for this one that goes across here. That one just goes across, although there is two bulkheads right there in the middle. But anyways, I don't think that's that big of a deal. But yeah, I just want to make the update to fill you in on what's going on, and probably getting ready to call it quits. It looks like it's getting ready to storm, and I'm going to coat both sides in resin, of course, and then I'm going to put one layer of 1.5 ounce chopped strand on the bottom of the entire floor, and then I'm going to put two layers on the top of the deck. But obviously I got to do the bottom layer first before I can glue it down. I'm probably going to use the thickened resin, the peanut butter, to glue it down and then screw it as well. And my plan for the screw holes is going to be to pre-drill them, and then right before I put the screw in, I'm going to pour some resin in the holes, and then I'll put the screw in, and then I'll cure up, and that should seal up the holes real nice, all the way, the entire like depth of the screw hole. And then of course I'm going to resin and put the two layers of chop strand over the top of the screws, so that should seal up everything really nice, and I should never have to worry about it. Obviously I am going to do tabbing from the deck onto the hole. You can see the areas I've ground up there in the bow. I did that all the way around. So there'll be do the fillets with the peanut butter and the two layers of 1708, just like I've been doing the stringers and everything else. And that should make this thing really nice and strong. And this deck should never go anywhere, but man, it is nice just to be able to walk around on this deck and just be able to walk and not have to step in and around stringers. So I'm excited. Hopefully I get to do some more work on Thursday and maybe get first coats of resin and maybe a little more work on the bow section, because I still got to do a little more work to the bulkheads back here, but it's coming along nice. So I'm getting pretty close to the deadline in September that I set for myself. I don't have to have everything done, but I'd like to have pretty much all the fiberglassing done by then. So like I said, today's July 31st, so that gives me about 2 months, a little less than 2 months to do it. So hopefully I'll get it. Just wanted to make a quick update on where I'm at with the boat. As you can see, I got my front section of floor glued down and screwed in. I got it glued in with the thickened resin, the peanut butter, and also got my fillets done all the way around the side of this front section here and down the seam. And also got the screw holes, got those filled up. I think I mentioned before I put resin down the screw hole and before I put the screw in, so hopefully that sealed up the actual hole itself pretty decent with resin. And then of course I put resin over top of it, and then the thickened resin, the peanut butter over that where there's a little recess. And so I got all that done, and I haven't coated the rest of it in resin. I coated the areas where I did my fillets in resin, but I need to coat the rest of it. But I've been kind of waiting until right before I lay my layer of chop strand down, just so I can put it kind of wet on wet and get a nice chemical bond. And like I mentioned, I'm going to do two layers of the 1.5 ounce chop strand matting on top. And I'm going to do that after I get done with the tabbing, which is what I'm coming out here to do this morning. I'm going to go ahead and cut my pieces out because I still have some 1708 left over from doing the tabbing on the stringers and other things. So I think I have enough left over to do my two layers all the way down to the rear of this front section of floor I got here. And so I ordered some more 1708, I ordered more chop strand, and 4 more gallons of resin, and also I'm almost out of
Cavasil and the chop fibers, which I used to make the thickened resin, the peanut butter, so I had to order all of that. So that should be here this afternoon, but I'm not going to get much time today to work on it. No time tomorrow, so hopefully the end of this week I can get this front part of the floor tabbed in and maybe even completely finished with the two layers of chop strand on there. So wanted to go ahead and get that done, and then I can start working on this back section of floor here, which I already have cut out. Got the plywood there. Got to do a little more trimming on it, and that's for this back section back here. And then there's going to be one more piece, a smaller piece back here. And so hopefully I can at least get started on that. I'm probably going to run out of resin before that time. I may have to get more chop strand as well. I'm not quite sure if I'm going to have enough with the stuff I ordered, but just taking it one step at a time and hoping to get this thing done pretty soon. I'll feel a lot better once the floor is completely glassed down, and that'll be a big milestone. I mean, it's already a big milestone just having the stringers done, all the bulkheads done, everything, and having started on the floor and got pretty good progress made on that. But once I get the floor completely glassed down, it's gonna be so nice. So anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and get to cutting out my pieces of 1708 for my tabbing up here, and show you the progress.
Today is August 9th, 2018, and just wanted to make a clip just to update on what I'm doing. So the main thing I did was I got the front section of floor tabbed in with two layers of 1708. It was pretty easy, actually. I already had my pieces cut out from like the beginning of this week. So all I had did was mix some resin and, wiped it down with acetone stone first and then mixed up some resin and laid out two strips all the way along the edges. I didn't do right there at the very end because when I lay the back section of floor down, I'm gonna kind of connect those two pieces together better up onto the hull. But I did the entire flat section up there all the way to the bow, and it was nice because I got to sit on the floor and didn't have to be sitting uneven on the stringer, so that was kind of nice. But as you can see, I also got some chop strand laid out back there. Before I quit today, I'm gonna put the first layer of 1.5 ounce chop strand on the top of the deck here. There's one on the bottom deck. I did that before I glued these two pieces of the front section of the floor down to seal the bottom up. But the top side's gonna get two layers of the 1.5 ounce chop strand. But for today and for right now, I'm just gonna do the one layer. That way, when I go to tab in the like bunk structures and everything up in the bow, I can tab that in and then put the second layer over that and cover that tabbing up, because chop strand seems like it works a little better for like a top layer than 1708, because 1708 has the stitching in it and the weave, and sometimes they can run and like pull up, you know, like a loose thread almost. So chop strand just seems to work better for a top layer, so I wanted to be able to cover up that any 1708 tabbing that I put down final, you know, before I gel coat basically. I also got the rear port side of the floor, which goes back here behind me. It's the bigger piece that I have. I got it final shaped because I had it cut out already, the plywood, when I cut my front section of floor out, but it needed a little bit of tweaking before I was completely done with it and the fit was perfect. So I did that, and then I got a coat of resin on it and the bottom layer of 1.5 ounce chop strand. So it's ready to be glued into the boat, and that's kind of the goal for this weekend, I think, depending on how much time I have. And but I think I'll be able to get that in. I placed a pretty big order with US Composites, and I got, I think, enough 1708 to complete the tabbing on the floor all the way around. And I got enough 1.5 ounce chop strand that I think I can coat the two remaining sections of floor on the bottom. I already coated the one big piece, like I said, and I should have enough to coat the top sides once. I don't know if I have enough to do both layers that I want to do, but you know, it is what it is. And then I've only got 4 gallons of resin, it's all I could afford, so I'm probably gonna have to get more before the floor's done, but you know, it is what it is. I thought about using PL glue to glue the floor down, but I think I'm gonna stick with the thickened resin because I know it works, and like I think I mentioned in the last video, PL glue, it has acted a little weird with fresh resin, so I'd rather just use the extra resin and glue the floor sections down with the thickened resin, the peanut butter, and not have to worry about it. So that's the plan. I think that's all I wanted to mention. Like I said, I got quite a bit done today. It doesn't seem like a lot, I guess, when you like look visually at the boat, but it's a lot of work just fitting everything and getting everything sanded and prepped for the resin and then mixing resin. You know, it takes a while. And just laying everything out and getting it laminated up. But I'm pretty happy with the progress, and it's moving right along. Hopefully I'll be able to get this floor done pretty soon. Definitely hope I can get it done by the end of August. I don't see why I wouldn't be able to, because I'm getting pretty close and it's not that big of a job. And then I'll be able to move on to the bunk structures and finishing up the transom. There's not too much to be done to it still. I've been drilling some of my holes and drilling them oversized and filling them with the thickened resin and then drilling them to the correct size so that they're all sealed up. The bolts are isolated from the wood, so that should help prevent rot and water intrusion. But I need to put, I want to put one layer of the chop strand on the outside of the transom, and then I want to put one layer of 1708 and then a layer of CSM on the inside of the transom just to make a nice inner skin and hold everything together nice. But I'm going to do that after I get done tabbing the floor in and everything. So I got to do that, and like I said, the bunk structures, and then got to figure out something for the seat boxes. So I'm kind of looking forward to that, and I want to see what I can come up with that. Try to make them lightweight but also strong and give me a little more room than the old ones had to be able to walk up and through the bow here into the cabin. So that's kind of the future projects for this thing. And you know, the fiberglass is dwindling down, which I'm very glad of. I'm getting tired of working with the fiberglass and grinding everything. There's very little grinding left to do, just a little bit up there around the top of the where the bunk structures go, and that'd be pretty much it. And you know, then I'll get to gel coat, which I'm very looking forward to that. I'm really looking forward to gel coating and finishing this thing out nice and pretty, and putting some kind of non-skid in it, in the gel coat. And then I get to move on to the cool stuff like rigging, like electrical and, you know, everything else. But all in good time. You gotta finish the fiberglass first. So that's enough rambling. I just wanted to make the update, and I'm gonna go ahead and mix up some resin and get that layer of chop strand on the front deck here.